The following testimony is of a woman who came to our prayer line with her husband seeking deliverance from spirits of anxiety and fear that came upon her after she became troubled about her husband's illnesses. As a result of this, she took antidepressants which opened her up to a suicidal spirit. These spirits tormented her for over a year.
I feel like the enemy attacked me through worry and fear, and I feel like he's been trying to destroy me, and I can't function. Every day has been torment. But when I got back on the antidepressant pill, I realized I didn't need it, and I tried to get off of it, and I started to become severely depressed.
We pray, depressed.
It's a chemical, and now I'm on three different
pills. You take
pills? I'm on three different pills, and nothing is helping me, and I blame myself for getting back on it.
As a spiritual person, you must know that that kind of pills destroy your life. They don't help you. That increase the demons.
Mm-hmm.
That because this spirit of anxiety comes to you and depress. Of the pills.
I want to get off of them. I want to get off of them.
And off of them if you increase your faith.
What?
You have that pills?
Yes.
You bring me here, please.
Okay.
Oh my God.
These are my pills.
Come in. We pray. Okay.
I thought about suicide this past year, and I know
that. You want to suicide yourself?
It wasn't from me. I know that because
the demons.
I love Jesus. Yes, and I know when I said I'm a
I know
Christian,
that you love Jesus.
How could they do this to me?
Lift your hand. We pray, Mom. Okay.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name, we pray. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Thank you.
Demonic. Fire in the Holy Spirit! Who are you?
I want to kill her. I want to kill her.
How many years you are in this body?
Oh, I've tried, but she always comes back. I've tried.
How many of you is together with you?
Three.
Her names. What names?
I.
Names!
Beelzebub and.
Beelzebub. Okay, what else?
Satan.
Hi, other.
The enemy.
Who is this man next to me?
Her husband.
Her husband?
Yes.
Who is this woman?
My wife.
But she say that her husband. She don't recognize you as husband.
Huh?
Fire of the Holy Spirit! Fire of the Holy Spirit! You must go out of this woman! Out! Come out! Come out, demons! Out! Out now!
They tell me you're wasting your time. They tell me you're wasting your time.
No. This is time. Your time expired. You're in the prayer line and don't lie to me. Okay? This is time to go out! 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 In Jesus' mighty name. Out darkness.
Oh God.
Out darkness. Out!
Oh God, help me. My name is Ann Smilowitz. I'm from Somerset, New Jersey. And for the past year and a half, I was in absolute hell. I was depressed and anxious, and I was in a 24-hour-a-day panic attack. Every minute was like being in the torments of hell. I lost 32 pounds. I had gotten onto an antidepressant and it was making me shake like anything. And the doctor put me on lorazepam, which is the generic form of Ativan. That made me so much worse. My husband was having health issues, so I let fear and worry set in. I've been saved since 1981 and I couldn't understand why Jesus was allowing this to happen. But I've come full circle and now I know why. I've met a lot of wonderful people through this, and I know I'm going to be able to give my testimony and share it. I saw John Zavlaris, I think it was in June, and at that point, I felt like I was at the verge of suicide, and I told him I wanted to kill myself, and I felt like the demons were telling me to do that. It started over a year and a half ago. I made the mistake, my brother-in-law has a terrible gambling addiction. I made the mistake of praying for his gambling addiction to leave. And it seemed that when I did that, that I started having problems. And I was worried about my husband had a problem with his eye, with his heart. He needed immediate detached retina surgery on his eye. A cousin of mine, her husband died during that surgery. And in my past, when I was 27, both my parents died within 3 weeks of each other. And 4 years after that, my only sister, she was 39, she died of ovarian cancer. So I had this fear inside of me whenever my husband got sick that something was going to happen. But I tried to hold on to my faith this past year and a half, and I cried out, I screamed to Jesus, why are you letting this happen going on for so long? But I never lost my faith, because the Bible said if we have a mustard seed of faith, that it's still there. And even though there were times I really, really felt like I couldn't take it anymore, I wanted to kill myself, I knew that the Holy Spirit wouldn't allow me to do that. But I kept repeating myself over and over to my husband, why is he letting this happen? Why is he letting this happen? I went to group therapy in North Brunswick for 3 months from June through August. And every day I told them I'm dizzy, I'm disoriented, I don't feel good, I'm shaking like anything, I can't stop. A doctor there put me on another medication, which was the wrong medication. He wouldn't get me off the Ativan, which I told him I need to get off this. And he said, why? I said, because, I said, it's destroying me. And he said, no, he said, I said, I'm addicted to it. He said, no, you're not addicted to it. And then the following week, he told me I was dependent on it. So I wanted to know what the difference was. But I couldn't stop taking it, because a doctor at, I went into New York Presbyterian Hospital from August 25th to September 13th. And a doctor there told me that the amount that I was taking and then lowering it, I could have actually died from that. So got a word for me. And this was after I was there for a week and a half. The word was directly from the Holy Spirit, and the word was restoration. God is going to fully restore you. At that point, I so wanted to believe, but I was still not myself. I was still shaking and depressed. About a week and a half's time, all of a sudden, I started feeling like myself again. And I got my sense of humor back, and I felt like the Holy Spirit came back to me. A week before I went into the hospital, it seems in my life, whenever I see a rainbow, something good is going to happen. And I prayed for a year and a half to see a rainbow in the sky. And it was a week before I was admitted to the hospital on August 25th. A week before that, it rained out that day, and I looked in the backyard, and I kept praying for a year and a half to see a rainbow. And there, from arc to arc, was a rainbow. The following day, there was the same rainbow in the sky. So he not only gave me one rainbow, he gave me two rainbows. But it was a process. And it started when I saw Apostle John Zavlaris, because when he delivered me that day, I wasn't instantaneously delivered. This was, I think, in June. And the deliverance happened in August. But I really felt like it started that day. And when he was praying over me, I was screaming and screaming and screaming, and I felt like I had three demons who were tormenting me. And when he pointed to my husband and he asked, who was that? My husband told me, I don't remember, but my husband told me, I said, that's her husband. That's her husband. But after he delivered me and he asked me who that was, I said, that's my husband. But I was still depressed after that. And the process came. It started with him, and thank God, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He never left me. He never abandoned me, even though I felt like he did. Believe me, I cried out so many nights I couldn't sleep for a year and a half, and I didn't look like the same person. I don't know what I look like, but I feel like that Jesus is real, he's alive, and he's there to help us. And the devil knows his time is short. We're living in the last days, and the devil knows his time is short, and he's trying to attack us Christians. But we have to hold on. We have to hold on, like the Bible says, like flint. We have to look directly at him, not to the right or to the left. And we have to keep that faith and not let fear or worry set in. Because when we do that, we open the door to the enemy. And we can't do that. We just have to give it all to Jesus and just keep trusting and believing him. One of my favorite passages in the Bible comes from Proverbs, and it's, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your paths. And he directed my path, even though I said, I had that three places in my Bible. Why didn't you direct my path in the right direction? But he did. He directed my path, and he took me out of the fiery furnace after a year and a half. So I just give all the praise and all the glory and all the honor to my Lord and my Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Thank you. Thank you.